listeners by just calling in and filling us in on everything. Now, our meteorologists, though, in this city, there's no one better. We got the best, top of the top. And one of them, maybe the top, in my opinion, Max Defender Chief Meteorologist Jeff Berardelli is on the Joe Show, taking time out of his very, very busy day. So thank you so much, first of all, for being on.
My pleasure. Glad to be here. Thank you for the compliment. You said the best in the city. I was looking all around. I'm like, who? Where?
You. Behind
you
me?
Are.
Jeff, you want to know what I... No, you want to know what I really appreciated yesterday? You tweeted that you guys figure out your plan. I got to promise for you. Figure out your plan, and I promise I'll handle the rest. And that's really what you guys have been doing, is keeping us calm. And thank you for that, and everyone at WFLA.
Well, that's our job. I've covered many a hurricane in my career down in South Florida, and I worked here back for many years, back around the year 2000. And I love it here. This is my city. This is why I came back. This is my home. And these are my people. And having, you know, done this so many times in my life, I'll tell you what, it doesn't do any good to panic, because you don't actually get anything accomplished. And half of the time, the storm ends up veering away from you. So you panic for no reason. That's wasted energy, the way I look at it.
Yeah.
So it's be prepared. It's it's simply have the peace of mind to know that you've taken care of yourself and your family, so that if immediate action is needed, you have everything in place to do so.
Jeff, where are we at now at 11:40 Tuesday, I guess, morning? I'm not used to being on this late.
Tuesday
what do people
afternoon.
Say?
Oh, Tuesday, it's Tuesday morning.
Is it the afternoon? I don't know how that works.
Before,
but anyways.
If it's before 12, it's still the a.m.
No way. I see. I'm,
yeah, I know. It's hard for you to believe that.
I'm normally going to sleep
like
now.
It's 3 o'clock at night here.
That's right. But so, Jeff, talk to us now. Where are we at with Hurricane Ian?
So the storm is strengthening. It's going to be a Cat 4 pretty soon. It's in the southeast Gulf of Mexico with a little hiccup as it passed over Cuba. It's a very narrow area of land, so it's not going to really do much to the storm, and it didn't. Now the storm's headed for a stronger Cat 4 status. Now, the newest track has indeed shifted to the southeast. Now, if you watched me last night at 11 o'clock, you saw I showed one of our computer models, our in-house News Channel 8 model, which was showing it kind of hooking to the east through Sarasota County. And it wasn't alone. There were at least a few others. And I'm not surprised that the National Hurricane Center has shifted the center of their track now over central Sarasota County. However, as I said last night also, and we always say, don't concentrate on the middle. Because, look, we're still 30 hours out from landfall, and there are still going to be some shifts, maybe further south again. That would be great for the Tampa Bay area, but it also could be further north. We remember Charley back in 2004, up until 18 hours before landfall, that storm was headed right into Tampa Bay, and literally at the last second, it took that hook and went into the Charlotte Harbor area, Fort Myers, Punta Gorda. So that's still conceivable. So we should, you know, as steady as she goes. We've been planning for a major hurricane strike here. Everybody has made their plans. They've evacuated or they're planning on evacuating. Just continue to do what it is that you were planning to do, because any shifts in the track could also shift back quickly.
Yeah.
But as it stands right now, if it takes that center of the cone through Sarasota County, most of Tampa Bay escapes the big storm surge that we thought was going to happen. However, there will be onshore flow around the St. Petersburg area. So on the west side of Tampa Bay, so in eastern Pinellas County, we'll have that onshore flow coming from the bay. So there may be a buildup of water there, but there may be a case again, just like Irma a few years ago, you probably remember, where you walk along Bayshore Boulevard and
there's no water.
Nothing there.
Water's been sucked out.
Yeah. So, Jeff, when that happens, I've been driving down Bayshore and looking out and going, is it going to, what's about to happen? When that happens, the water has, is that the storm? So break down the storm surge for us, which is what we're being told that we really need to be ready for.
It's the biggest concern.
Well, it has been, you know, and it's still the biggest concern in Manatee County and Sarasota County and parts of Tampa Bay. But to be honest with you, the concern is switching from Tampa Bay north right now. It's been an interesting phenomenon. On the computer models for days, they have been showing by far the strongest winds and the heaviest rain, especially on the northwestern side of the system. Now, that is odd. Typically, the heaviest rain is on the eastern side of the system. Typically, the strongest winds are also on the eastern side of the system. But the fact that every model has been showing this for various days, there's something dynamical going on in the atmosphere with kind of this convergence with wind shear in the northern Gulf. You've probably been hearing that if this went further north, it would run into this wall of wind shear and weaken rapidly. And I always thought it was odd that our computer models have been defying logic and physics, trying to push against this wall of wind shear near the panhandle, yeah, and still trying to move the storm north. Didn't make much sense to me, and I think a lot of meteorologists probably felt the same way. And sure enough, the models are like, oh, yeah, I can't do that. I'm going to go east now. So we always had an inclination, at least I did, I should say, I can't speak for other meteorologists, that this was going to hook. The question was always, how much of a hook was it going to take, and how quick would it take it? So just to let you know, on the northwest side of this system, it is not inconceivable that we see 20 inches of rain. And that very well could be right over Tampa Bay, Pinellas, and Hillsborough County. Yeah. In fact, one of our models has 40 inches of rain.
Wow.
Now, that's not likely to happen. The reason why that happens, that particular model stalls out for a longer period of time. I think that that is an error. But there are a number of models that show a narrow band of 20 inches of rain. And I think that is conceivable. And the reason why I think it's conceivable is because you probably have seen this thing is going to slow down. In addition to that, on the north side of this storm and the northwest side of this track tend to be the strongest winds. So it's conceivable if the storm makes landfall in central Sarasota County that we're going to have hurricane-force winds all the way north to St. Pete, maybe almost to Tampa. Then, of course, the system was stronger when it made landfall because it didn't have to run into that wind shear. So now it's able to cut across Florida again, just kind of like Charlie did, although probably weakening faster than Charlie did. That would be the good news. But still carry those hurricane-force winds into inland parts of the Bay Area. You know, right now, that would put interior Hillsborough in hurricane-force winds.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe
yeah.
even parts of Polk County and Hardy County and, DeSoto County as well. So, again, things change quickly, right? And the impacts change quickly just with these small 25-mile shifts in expected track.
Well, listen, guys, we've got Max Defender Chief Meteorologist Jeff Berardelli on the Joe Show, and yeah, we're on a bit later, but this is why. We want to make sure you guys are informed, and Jeff, I'm just thinking about, you know, the community and our listeners who hear you say, hey, this could be kind of moving east, and with that, maybe I don't have to evacuate now.
Mm-hmm.
It's still very important to be following what we're being told, right? If we were told to evacuate, get out.
Yeah, and I say that because, look, it just shifted the center of the track in one forecast from the National Hurricane Center from 5 a.m. today to 11 a.m. this morning, so 6 hours. It shifted from the storm being right over Tampa Bay to the storm moving 30 miles south. What's to say that later today, that track doesn't shift 30 miles back north? At this point, you just have to go with your plan because it is too dangerous to take a chance. Do we think it's going to take a shift 30 miles further north again? Probably not, just because we're getting closer to landfall, which is only 30 hours out or so.
Mm-hmm.
That's another good point I should let you know. Yes, so you do want to follow through with whatever you were planning to do at this point. It's just too risky to kind of all
to
of
change
a sudden
plans, yeah.
Put off your plans. And then all of a sudden the track changes. But you probably want to know when it begins, right?
Yeah,
I mean, I'm sure
absolutely.
Everybody wants to know the timeline.
Absolutely.
So the tropical storm force winds will start to get squally weather later today and tonight, mostly tonight. We could be in tropical storm force sustained winds by tomorrow morning across Tampa Bay. Obviously, it begins earlier down south in Manatee and Sarasota County. It starts earlier the further south you are in the middle of the night. And the further north you are on the Nature Coast, northern Pinellas County, it takes a little longer. Those tropical storm force winds don't get to you probably until tomorrow afternoon. Now, landfall, if it were to happen in Sarasota County where they say it's going to happen, it's likely to happen later tomorrow and tomorrow night. So it would be starting tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening, and tomorrow night that the worst conditions would be. And that means hurricane force winds, you know, anywhere within, I'd say, 30 miles north of the center and 30 miles south of the center, and potentially even slightly further than that. That's about the size of the wind field right now. Of course, that could change a little.
Jeff, I'm always curious, where do you go during this? When, you know, let's say, God forbid, worst case scenario, the eye went right towards us. Do you guys broadcast out of a bunker? I know I'm asking
where
like
do you
a
go
question
for safety?
That some people are like, what are you, a nerd? But I'm just always curious with that.
What do I do? I stay right there on the air as long
absolutely
as I possibly can. and provide coverage. So I will be in the News Channel 8 building. And, you know, it's a pretty – if you've seen the building, it's a bit like a fortress. Of course, the only issue we have is storm surge flooding because we're right on the river. But at this point, it's seeming less likely that we're going to see that 10 feet of storm surge here, and in which case storm surge we should be okay with. And, our building is really solid and strong. But regardless of all that, my first priority is protecting you. So my family, I sent them away, just away from the storm into a hotel because I, don't want to have to worry about my family at the same time I'm worrying about my viewers.
Is it tough?
Job.
Is it tough while you're trying to cover the hurricane, having your family leave?
I mean, I would say no, because it gives me peace of mind.
Yeah.
I'd rather know that they're safe and far away from the storm. At the same standpoint, what I do, and this is the moment that I need to be at the top of my game, and I can't be splitting my time between worrying about my family and worrying about my community. If I can send my family to a place where I know they'll be safe, then I can dedicate 100% of my resources to you.
And I'm sure you're also giving your wife and family updates on how you're doing.
Oh, they get the most up-to-date updates.
Yeah, they get the tea before we get it.
Television or Facebook or...
Oh, YouTube. They don't get the hookup? They don't even get a text?
Listen, my father texted me last night. He says, hey, I thought I was the only guy who didn't know how to use Facebook. I'm questioning how he saw me if he doesn't know how to use Facebook, but whatever.
I love that.
For another time.
This has meant so much for so many reasons. Max Defender, Chief Meteorologist Jeff Berardelli, on the Joe Show right now. You are calming the city and also just keeping us informed, which I appreciate it. Any last words as we're about to sign off and get out of here? I gotta go take my girlfriend up to Kissimmee. Anything that you got that we need to know before we'll be watching you later?
Like I said before, steady as she goes. And I would say this, don't worry, because I'm not worried at all. I tend never to worry in situations like this, but I'm confident that we are in good position right now to all be safe here. I would just say that.
All right. Well, then, all right. Here. Then let me ask you this question, because I'm that dummy who's listening to you and going, do I really have to leave? Do I have to leave or not? What do I got to do, Jeff?
I would go. I mean, listen, you go to Kissimmee. I would just say this to you. If you go to Kissimmee, you might also experience tropical storm force or even hurricane force gusts. But here's the thing. If you stay here, and I don't know what kind of structure you live in, so I can't possibly give you advice.
I'm going to break it down. No, listen, if I get them on, I'm going to talk to them about this. So I live at these apartments. They're called Town West Shore. They're right at West Shore and Gandy, right where the bridge is in Tampa. Uh-huh. It's like literally on the water. So that's what I'm afraid about.
Yeah.
Is keep talking about the storm surge.
Although I think that the good bet would be on the storm surge not being a big deal now because the storm's going south.
Thank goodness.
That's no better than even. And if this storm truly does move, just shift back north again, then you're right in the middle of harm's way, and boy, did you make a bad decision.
Absolutely.
So go to Kissimmee. The worst you're not going to see storm surge there. You'll get some winds. You may even get a power outage or two in Kissimmee, but at least you would have avoided what is truly the life-threatening part of the storm, which is storm surge. You can protect yourself from wind by being in an interior part of a hotel room or a home if you're inland and, you're away from the windows. You can't protect yourself from the surge if you're right on the water.
Absolutely. Well, listen, WFLA's Max Defender, Chief Meteorologist Jeff Berardelli.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate you because I know you're busier than ever, and thank you for taking the time out of your day to just talk to us.
My pleasure, and good luck to everybody.
All right, praying for you and your family, and thank you, and we'll talk to you soon.
Okay, sounds good.
All right. Ashley, we are about to get out of here. Any final thoughts before we... We sign off, but I want to let you guys all know that we are on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all of those at Live with Joe Show, at Ashley Nix, at Producer Jed, at Joe Show Sucks. As long as I've got service and anything like that, I'm going to be doing a bunch of lives and check-ins, and I will, of course, make it mandatory that Ashley and Jed join. Ashley, anything else?
Everybody. Please be safe. Do what is best for you, and I cannot wait, hopefully, to be back in this studio tomorrow talking to you at 6 a.m. in the morning.
That's right. Jed?
I am eager to get out of here. I will do my best to get...
What?
What do you mean?
What do you mean? You want to leave?
I mean, I want to get
we're
the...
We're kind of like signing off. I mean... It's a good vibe. Like, we're happy.
Well, I want to...
our first show till noon.
I'm just... I'm nervous
we're
that...
We're really trying to make sure that we're making everyone calm right now. What are you nervous about?
I'm just saying I'm eager to get out of here. Eager. There's could be good nervous energy, bad nervous energy. It's good nervous energy because I think by the end of this thing, we will be okay.
I'm nervous about driving. All the traffic.
I've got good calls about traffic. I think we're going to be fine.
And speaking of the calls, if you missed today, there's one thing I want to highlight amongst a bunch. And it's on our Instagram. You can watch the video because right now I genuinely believe we can't control the weather, but we can control our emotions, our preparation, and how we treat each other. There was a moment in our show this morning where a woman called in and didn't have shelter for her kids and her animal. And in minutes, we had someone call in. And we actually had multiple people call in and text in offering shelter. And now she's going to be safe. You can see that on Instagram, at Live with Joe Show. That was Gabby in Hudson. So listen, guys, that right there needs to be the type of mentality we have over the next couple of days, because God forbid anything happens, I know that us as a community, us as Tampa Bay, we're going to get through all of this. I promise you that. Let's be prepared. Be safe. We love you. We'll be back as soon as we can. And if that's in the afternoon at some point one day, so be it. If it's at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, thank God. And one last thing. Thank God. It's the power of prayer. Right now, that's what we have. And know that I'm going to be saying a prayer for all of you as soon as I get off the air. All right? We love you. And
take care of yourself, Tampa Bay.
Joe Show will be back incredibly soon. I hope tomorrow. And now, a 16-minute Where is the Love? No, I'm just kidding. We're signing off. Later.
A lot of very slow traffic eastbound on I-4, anywhere from the Selman Connector to Charlie Taylor Road. Tack on an extra 48 minutes through this stretch. Eastbound is also slow in eastern Polk County from east of 557 past Osceola Polk Line Road, so tack on an extra 36 minutes to get through here. We also have a lot of slow traffic northbound on I-75 from the Selman to I-4 and northbound 275 from Kennedy to Ashley. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595 from the Traffic Center. I'm Daisy Ash.
We identify as WFLZ Tampa Bay.
An iHeartRadio station.
Turn it up.
93.3 FLZ.
Wake up with us, The Joe Show.
Weekday mornings.
Thank you, Nikki. I love you. Got that big rocket launcher.
FLZ plays the most commercial-free music in Tampa Bay.
93.3 FLZ.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco, and I feel like any good boyfriend right now is cooking 2 to 4 meals to have ahead of time for his girlfriend, because the one thing any girl's going to need in lockdown, options for food. It's 93.3 FLZ.
Need a boy.
What I really want.
Hi, this is Taylor Swift.
This is The Weeknd.
On 93.3 FLZ.
So this is my first hurricane. I'm getting ready. Ian is coming our way. Supposed to get kind of ugly later on today. Make sure you're following Operation Storm Watch right now, 93.3 FLZ, and have a buddy to hang out with.
That my best friend.
93.3 FLZ. On the Verge artist.
Steve Lacy. Bad Habits.
Hit music.
You're checking out Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ.
Now, the latest Operation Stormwatch update from News Radio WFLA. Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
I'm Reed Shepard, News Radio WFLA. We continue to follow the track of Hurricane Ian, which is now a Category 3 storm just off the coast of Cuba with a well-defined eye, top winds of 115 miles an hour. The 11 a.m. track of the storm has shifted slightly to the south and east of the Tampa Bay area. Now, even though we could still see some movement one way or another, it now appears as if the center of Ian might
might come ashore somewhere around Venice. Now that, if that were to happen, that would increase the storm surge threat to our south and lower it somewhat here in the immediate Bay Area, but we would still feel the full effect of the wind and the rain. Hillsborough County has ordered a mandatory evacuation for residents in Zone A, B, and C. Pinellas County has issued a mandatory evacuation for Zone A. Zones B and C had that same order go into effect this morning at 7 a.m. And Pasco County, everyone west of U.S. 19. Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA.
Keep your phone charged and download the free iHeartRadio app to make sure you'll never miss important weather information from News Radio WFLA's Operation Stormwatch.
Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
Well, for those of you that are evacuating, coming up from Sarasota, just a heads up north on I-75, there's a crash at Fruitville Road taking up the right lane. We're seeing very heavy volume, too, coming off the Howard Franklin Bridge into Tampa, north on 275, as well as eastbound on I-4 between 301 out past McIntosh Road. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595. From the Traffic Center, I'm Paige Carrera.
Available everywhere on our free iHeartRadio app.
Number one for music, radio, and podcast all in one.
93.3 FLZ.
Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
Commercial free, FLZ.
FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco. All right, so the one thing I think I'm doing right with hurricane preparedness is downloading content onto my phone from the different streaming services. You can even do it with the iHeartRadio app. Download that Joe Show podcast. But I'm downloading as much as I can because I'm going to lose the internet and it's going to happen quicker than I'm going to be prepared.
Pray for my demons, girl. I got you.
Summer's technically over, but thirst trap season is never over.
93.3 FLZ.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? It's Taco. All right, as things intensify, you're going to hear us switch over to our 24-7 wall-to-wall coverage. That's going to be right here. 93.3 FLZ, Operation Stormwatch, 93.3FLZ.com. Stay up on everything.
Girl, I like you. I do.
93.3 FLZ.
2 hours commercial free every weekday at 3:45.
FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco. The biggest energy at any hurricane party is the tequila. Whoever has the tequila, hurricane buddy for life. It's 93.3 FLZ.
FLZ. Now, the latest Operation Stormwatch update from News Radio WFLA. Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
I'm Reed Shepard, News Radio WFLA. We continue to follow the track of Hurricane Ian, which is now a Category 3 storm just off the coast of Cuba with a well-defined eye, top winds of 115 miles an hour. The 11 a.m. track of the storm has shifted slightly to the south and east of the Tampa Bay area. Now, even though we could still see some movement one way or another, it now appears as if the center of Ian might come ashore somewhere around Venice. Now that, if that were to happen, that would increase the storm surge threat to our south and lower it somewhat here in the immediate Bay Area, but we would still feel the full effect of the wind and the rain. Hillsborough County has ordered a mandatory evacuation for residents in Zone A, B, and C. Pinellas County has issued a mandatory evacuation for Zone A. Zones B and C had that same order go into effect this morning at 7 a.m. And Pasco County, everyone west of U.S. 19. Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA.
Keep your phone charged and download the free iHeartRadio app to make sure you'll never miss important weather information from News Radio WFLA's Operation Stormwatch.
Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
Well, for those of you that are evacuating, coming up from Sarasota, just a heads up north on I-75, there's a crash at Fruitville Road taking up the right lane. We're seeing very heavy volume, too, coming off the Howard Franklin Bridge into Tampa, north on 275, as well as eastbound on I-4 between 301 out past McIntosh Road. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595. From the Traffic Center, I'm Paige Carrera.
We identify as WFLZ Tampa Bay.
An iHeartRadio station.
Turn it up.
93.3 FLZ.
Wake up with us. The Joe Show.
Weekday morning.
I've been... Yeah. I love the nonstop music.
Commercial free.
FLZ.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? It's Taco. Everything you need for Hurricane Ian. Operation Stormwatch. 93.3FLZ.com. As you get your hurricane party started. There's always that one person that's going to eat all the food right away. That's why we're 93.3
FLZ. Hi, I'm Leslie from Tarpon Springs, and I love 93.3 FLZ.
I can't pass on my clothes. 93.3 FLZ.
What's up? My name is Taco, and let's go ahead and get into it. I think Doja Cat would be a great person to have to lock down on a hurricane with. Hunker down with Doja Cat. Things gonna get weird, and it's gonna be awesome. 93.3 FLZ.
93.3 FLZ.
What's up? My name is Taco. All right, so I'm worried about just like a couple things, and one is having enough food. And you know what? I have more than enough food, but I'm scared I'm going to eat it all. It's 93.3 FLZ.
I don't know what you've been worried about it.
Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ.
Now, the latest Operation Stormwatch update from News Radio WFLA. Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
I'm Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA. We continue to follow the track of Hurricane Ian, which is now a Category 3 storm just off the coast of Cuba with a well-defined eye, top winds of 115 miles an hour. The 11 a.m. track of the storm has shifted slightly to the south and east of the Tampa Bay area. Now, even though we could still see some movement one way or another, it now appears as if the center of Ian might come ashore somewhere around Venice. Now that, if that were to happen, that would increase the storm surge threat to our south and lower it somewhat here in the immediate Bay Area, but we would still feel the full effect of the wind and the rain. Hillsborough County has ordered a mandatory evacuation for residents in Zone A, B, and C. Pinellas County has issued a mandatory evacuation for Zone A. Zones B and C had that same order go into effect this morning at 7 a.m. And Pasco County, everyone west of U.S. 19. Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA.
Keep your phone charged and download the free iHeartRadio app to make sure you'll never miss important weather information from News Radio WFLA's Operation Stormwatch.
Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
Well, for those of you that are evacuating, coming up from Sarasota, just a heads up north on I-75, there's a crash at Fruitville Road taking up the right lane. We're seeing very heavy volume, too, coming off the Howard Franklin Bridge into Tampa, north on 275, as well as eastbound on I-4 between 301 out past McIntosh Road. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595. From the Traffic Center, I'm Paige Carrera.
Follow 93.3 FLZ on the iHeartRadio app and follow us in the app to keep up to date.
I got my head up. Commercial free. FLZ.
Boys and girls want to hear what you story.
So I call Lightline.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? It's Taco. Operation Stormwatch. 93.3FLZ.com's got everything you need to know. Keep yourself like very educated on what's going on so you can make your plans in a smart way. 93.3 FLZ.
Things haven't been cool night. Talking.
93.3 FLZ.
You ain't nothing but
93.3 FLZ.
Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ.
Discover new music first.
All right, we got the new one from Nicki Minaj. It's Super Freaky Girl. It's like the perfect partner to be locked down with in a hurricane. You got a super freak in the sheets, and then you realize that she's scared of thunder, and it's just not gonna happen. It's 93.3 FLZ.
Hey, girl, I can.
FLZ. What's up? It's Taco. Tampa International shut down 5 p.m. tonight, and they are advising people, do not park your cars there. That is not what that is for. It's 93.3 FLZ.
Now, the latest Operation Stormwatch update from News Radio WFLA. Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
I'm Reed Shepard, News Radio WFLA. We continue to follow the track of Hurricane Ian, which is now a Category 3 storm just off the coast of Cuba with a well-defined eye, top winds of 115 miles an hour. The 11 a.m. track of the storm has shifted slightly to the south and east of the Tampa Bay area. Now, even though we could still see some movement one way or another, it now appears as if the center of Ian might come ashore somewhere around Venice. Now that, if that were to happen, that would increase the storm surge threat to our south and lower it somewhat here in the immediate Bay Area, but we would still feel the full effect of the wind and the rain. Hillsborough County has ordered a mandatory evacuation for residents in Zone A, B, and C. Pinellas County has issued a mandatory evacuation for Zone A. Zones B and C had that same order go into effect this morning at 7 a.m. And Pasco County, everyone west of U.S. 19. Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA.
Keep your phone charged and download the free iHeartRadio app to make sure you'll never miss important weather information from News Radio WFLA's Operation Stormwatch.
Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
Well, for those of you that are evacuating, coming up from Sarasota, just ahead north on I-75, there's a crash at Fruitville Road taking up the right lane. We're seeing very heavy volume, too, coming off the Howard Franklin Bridge into Tampa, north on 275, as well as eastbound on I-4 between 301 out past McIntosh Road. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595. From the Traffic Center, I'm Paige Carrera.
We identify as WFLZ Tampa Bay.
An iHeartRadio station.
Turn it up.
93.3 FLZ.
Wake up with us, The Joe Show.
Weekday mornings.
Oh, girl, I like you. 93.3 FLZ, Operation Stormwatch. 93.3FLZ.com's got everything you need to know.
Give me some time to think. I'm in the bathroom.
Whenever me and my girlfriends are getting ready, you're all we listen to. You are our getting ready music.
93.3 FLZ.
Now, the latest Operation Stormwatch update from News Radio WFLA. Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
I'm Reed Shepard, News Radio WFLA. We continue to follow the track of Hurricane Ian, which is now a Category 3 storm just off the coast of Cuba with a well-defined eye, top winds of 115 miles an hour. The 11 a.m. track of the storm has shifted slightly to the south and east of the Tampa Bay area. Now, even though we could still see some movement one way or another, it now appears as if the center of Ian might come ashore somewhere around Venice. Now that, if that were to happen, that would increase the storm surge threat to our south and lower it somewhat here in the immediate Bay Area, but we would still feel the full effect of the wind and the rain. Hillsborough County has ordered a mandatory evacuation for residents in Zone A, B, and C. Pinellas County has issued a mandatory evacuation for Zone A. Zones B and C had that same order go into effect this morning at 7 a.m. And Pasco County, everyone west of U.S. 19. Reed Shepard, News Radio, WFLA.
Keep your phone charged and download the free iHeartRadio app to make sure you'll never miss important weather information from News Radio WFLA's Operation Stormwatch.
Brought to you by New South Window Solutions.
Well, for those of you that are evacuating, coming up from Sarasota, just a heads up north on I-75, there's a crash at Fruitville Road taking up the right lane. We're seeing very heavy volume, too, coming off the Howard Franklin Bridge into Tampa, north on 275, as well as eastbound on I-4 between 301 out past McIntosh Road. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at 866-545-9595. From the Traffic Center, I'm Paige Carrera.
Our device to play 93.3 FLZ on iHeartRadio. Oh, and we're still available in your car, too.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco. Make sure you got us locked and loaded on the free iHeartRadio app for all the updates. Everything Hurricane Ian, Operation Stormwatch, 93.3 FLZ.com. Keep that until you lose your internet, and then jump right on over to the old school battery dial one, 93.3.
This is 93.3 FLZ.
Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco. We're looking at the latest projections. Operation Stormwatch. See it right there. 93.3 FLZ.com. You click on it. It'll give you the map, the little projections. And that is updated as soon as we get that information. So just keep that ready to go. 93.3 FLZ.com.
What's going on, y'all? This is Post Malone.
Yo, it's Billie Eilish.
I'm Joe.
And I'm Ashley.
From The Joe Show on 93.3 FLZ, Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ.
Discover new music first.
Hey, it's Lil Nas X.
Lil Nas X, Star Walkin'.
FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco, and I'm just thinking about all the bad TikTok dances that are about to be had tonight at hurricane parties. Everything you need to know. Operation Stormwatch. 93.3 FLZ.com.
It's bad. It's about damn time.
Commercial free. FLZ.
Yeah, it's still a thing.
93.3 FLZ.
What's up? My name is Taco. All right, so when the internet goes out, what do you do? Oh my gosh, how do I watch and binge anything? DVD collection. That's why I still have it. For when the internet's out. It's 93.3 FLZ.
Pray for my demons.
This is 93.3 FLZ, Tampa Bay's number one hit music channel.
93.3 FLZ. What's up? My name is Taco. And you know, the one thing I really want for the lockdown for a little hurricane party is just a buttload of tequila and, you know, somebody to drink it with. It's 93.3 FLZ.
Now we're in windows down singing at a red light season.
93.3 FLZ.
Meh. 93.3 FLZ. What's up? It's Taco. We got Nick Wise coming in next. So we are going commercial free. Let's see, at 3:45. Operation Stormwatch. 93.3 FLZ.com. Got all the updates. Hurricane Ian. Everybody be safe. And, you know, we'll see what happens tomorrow. It's 93.3 FLZ.
They're made for me and you.
Commercial free.
That's what gets people going.
Commercial free. FLZ.
So good.
93.3 FLZ.
We identify as WFLZ Tampa Bay.
An iHeartRadio station.
Turn it up.
93.3 FLZ.
Wake up with us, The Joe Show.
Weekday mornings.